So I'm glad to be here to give this talk that we made in collaboration with I am Wendell Simon from here. And it's a collaboration between the University of Cartagena in Spain and us in Tecumwelan. This guy is in Lebanon now, so we also have a Lebanon Middle East with us. So it's about the video transmission in Ethernet. So Ethernet means heterogeneous networks. So if we make a transition with the previous panel discussion, multimedia sensing will mean network video uploading. So this can be a huge amount of video traffic. Cellular networks are a bit overwhelmed by the video traffic right now. So to fix this, okay, it doesn't work like this. So cellular networks gather a lot of video traffic, and one of the issues is on the access networks. So to deal with this issue, 3GPP, which is the standard group for cellular networks, promotes heterogeneous networks. So it means that the base station, which is the macro E-node B in the LTE 4G cellular networks, are augmented with pico E-node Bs or femtocells. Pico cells, femtocells, this is a small base station that allow people who are just around to have better access to the to the networks. So it's not an easy task to manage heterogeneous networks. Actually, there have been a lot of works in this direction. Basically, we distinguish into two previous works. One is about the practical works, which deal with what kind of algorithm or strategies for the management of heterogeneous networks to deploy, and it is based. So the evaluation, performance evaluation of these works are based on simulations, and there have been some works from theory standpoint with people who are doing optimization, and these works were dealt with how to manage the downlink of the heterogeneous networks, which means how to make sure that the cellular phones, the smartphones, will receive information at the massive scale. So how to deal with network management. So what we see now that we have smartphones with video capturing devices. And we see technologies like WebRTCs, which allow people to make video conferences or multimedia applications in real time. And so we see a lot of traffic, video traffic on the uplink, meaning that smartphones want to, or any sensors, but especially smartphones in our case, want to upload live video on the cellular network. And this is an issue that was not expected at this extent by the network operators. So our motivation is to study the uplink of videos in heterogeneous networks. And we are a team, we are working on optimization on theoretical points. So we are mostly this kind of guys, theoretical works. And what we have a contribution is that we work on the uplink, so it was done on the downlink previously. So our contribution is twofold. The first one is we made an optimization framework, which means that we designed a model that allow to compute the optimal performances that can be obtained by uploading videos using leveraging all the pico and femto E-node Bs. So this is an optimization framework, which means that it is something that can be used offline. So it means that to make a computation of the optimal performances, we need several minutes or hours. So if somebody moves in this time, it's with all our efforts. So it means that it is not down to be implemented right now as a network management tool. It is something that can be used to evaluate the performances of strategies that can be deployed. And it can also be used to configure networks and to network diagram sharing. Okay. And the second contribution that we make in this paper is that we provide some performance evaluation. So the number of pages was quite restricted, so we did not go very deep into the results because we wanted to focus on the mathematical model. So you will not find an extensive, comprehensive performance evaluation in the paper, but it just shows what kind of performance evaluation we can do using our model. So what are these network management processes that we have to deal with when in the case of heterogeneous networks? So the first one is a user cell association. So basically you have a lot of different eNode Bs, base stations that are available, and you are a mobile phone, so you have to decide which eNode Bs you need to connect to. And you can decide to connect to the macro base station always, because you are in the cell of the macro base station, but you can also decide to connect to one picocell kitchen nearby, or maybe you have several picocells nearby. So you have this decision to take. The second decision to take is at each eNode Bs you have what is called resource block in the LTE standard group. So you have a set of resource block, and every second it is free, and so you have to share the resource blocks to the different users that are connected to the base station. And in the case of uplink, you need to set the terminal power control. So every time you send a message or every time you send data to the eNode Bs, you have to set your power control so that you will be sure that you will reach the eNode Bs and that you will not have a loss of power. So this is the main difference between the uplink on the downlink model, because in the downlink model the eNode Bs always send with the same power control. Here you can decide what is the power of the transmitter control, and it has an impact on the interferences, and it has an impact on the resource blocks and on the channel gain of the resource blocks. And the fourth processes that you need to care of is the interference management. So basically you have a spectrum, a frequency, and you can share the frequency in different manners. You can decide to make an orthogonal deployment, which means that the eNode Bs, the macro eNode Bs has some of the frequencies that are reserved for it, and all the pico eNode Bs share the remaining, or you can have a lot of different interference management, which means how it will have a big impact, of course, on the interference and so on the channel gain on each resource blocks that you have in available. So these four management processes interplay, and so they combine to each other, and so it makes that the models for the performance evaluation can be quite tricky. So when we deal with video uplink, we have a model, so I go very quickly on it, although it's a big part of the paper. I just give some hints, because otherwise it would be much complicated. So what we want is to have, we consider only the smartphone who are emitting video, so every user in the cell emits one video stream, and we basically say that the uploader who is uploading video is satisfied, is as satisfied as the one who could get the video. So it is satisfied as the QME of the video that it emits. It means basically that if I communicate with Skype and somebody else, I am satisfied if the video that I am transmitting is of good quality, in fact. Okay? So we deal with the query of the emitted videos, and the query of the emitted videos is a function of the bitrate. So we took some real measures of query on bitrate to make the analysis, and we put a minimum bitrate. We say that one mobile phone cannot send a video if the bitrate is available bitrate on the uplink is lower than a certain value. And our goal could be something else, but we decided to maximize the average QoE of the uploaders, or maximize the sum of the QoE of everybody. So we want to, so we could put some fairness in this process too. So we could add a constraint like we want to be sure that we have at least 90% of the people who are served, or we could put the fairness into the maximization objective, like we want to maximize the proportional fairness, something like that. But we did not, but the model can obviously be used for the same kind of things. So what we did is this kind of math. I will not go into every equation, but I just want, I mean, I'm here to make sure that you will read the paper, and so I prefer to be honest. It's a kind of like this, but it's readable. Come on, you can do it. But so we maximize the stuff, and otherwise it's quite complicated. So we had one issue in this model. So in the previous model, what was good was we were able to fix the problems of dealing with the power transmission of the smartphone, which was the main issue, the main feature works that was said in previous works, which dealt only with downlink. But we still have an issue, is that we need to we need the channel capacity per resource block to compute the number of the bitrate which is available for each user, and we need this channel capacity per resource block as an input of the problem. But to get the channel capacity per resource blocks, we need to measure the interference level at the inode B, at each inode B. On the interference level at the inode B depends on the solution of what we have. So it means that we have to have something input, we need to solve the problem. So we have a kind of chicken egg problem. And so we solve this problem fix this problem in an unoptimal way, which is an iterative process where we have a first instance where we say, okay, let's consider that we have a value for the channel capacity, and the value is computed by having each user connected to the closest inode B, and by having all the resource blocks, this inode B, being equally shared among all the user, which is a kind of heuristic, okay? And we get a value for the channel capacity, and from this value, we can then compute and repeat the computation of the problem with this value as an input of the instance. And we can, every time we have the channel capacity as an input, we can solve the problem with the channel capacity, and we can compare what is the channel capacity at the end computed by the interference level. We can compare the channel capacity as the output and the input, and if they are close to each other, it means that we have found the best solution. We have found the optimization process. So we did not go very far into the details here. And in the paper, it's a bit shortly described. But we made a lot of computations to make sure that we are close to the optimality. So we go to the performance evaluation. So here we have the use case. So we have a use case with one, we try to find a typical use case. So we think to our friend in Oslo dealing with the soccer scenario. So we think that we have one macro base station. We have here one stadium with a soccer match there. And in this stadium, they put some pico cells because they want to add some more capacity to the networks at exactly this point. But obviously, there are more people there too, so it's a bit complicated. When we go into cellular networks, we also have to deal with a lot of parameters. So we spent actually a long time trying to get information from experts into cellular networks to have numbers for the parameters which looks reasonable for cellular networks guy and network operators. So don't ask me a question about this, or talk to my lawyer if you ask questions. I don't know anything about this, but at least it is something that has been proved. We have one resource only for this. And the last point is that we make some measurements of videos in order to have the quality of experience per bitrate. So what we did here is that for each circle, it's points that we actually measure. We measure the 1 minus VQM scale, which is an objective, which is something that can be used to estimate the quality of experience based on the, So what we did is that all the circles are actually measured the quality of experience for some representative video. I don't remember which one it was, but it was probably a sport video. And so we make a fitting curve in order to have the quality of experience for any value of the rate. And we consider that user, if they have, say, 329 kilobits per second available, they can actually emit a video at this level. And so we measure the QoE that we consider a kind of ideal WebRTC technologies that fully used the available bitrate. And so we measure it for several resolutions so that we were able to test a video service that could set the resolution of the clients, and so they could say, okay, I want my clients to use 720p video for the uploading. So among the different results that we present, I selected 2 results. Here it's basically measure the satisfaction of user in terms of maximization of the QoE, and we compare to the case of without picocell. So we only have the macrocell, and we measure how people, what is the performance, what is the QoE for the people, and then we add more picocells, and we see the satisfaction that grows. And here we have 2 interference management. Interference management is one of the key management process that the network operators have to decide when they deploy this kind of heterogeneous networks. And in fact, what we see is that there is no trivial answer. There is no trivial, we cannot say, hey, network operators, do the co-channel deployment, it is better. In fact, it is not. It actually depends on the number of picocells in our scenario. So it means that if we have other kind of scenarios, it can also change a lot. It means that the interference management can has a big impact on the performances of the system, and it's quite unpredictable, which means that if we want to have the best configuration and the best deployment management process in the network, you actually have to put this kind of framework and to measure it in order to decide what is the best. And the difference can be something like 5% sometimes. And the second result that we wanted to show is something a little bit more complicated, which is So we have here the CDF of the users, and we have the user satisfaction on the y-axis, and we have three kinds of scenarios. Scenario with the highest resolution, so in this case, and we have here 0 picocells, so only the microcell, and here we increase the number of picocells. So it means that when we have only the microcell, we can see that we are only able to serve 10% of the people, so only 10% of the users can send their videos, their 720 videos. And if we have 9 picocells, we are able to serve almost, more than 1/3 of the users. And this is the limit at which we decided that the user could not send anything here. And in fact, we see that there is a kind of slow increase of the video. And some of these guys have betrayed, the QoE, which is more than 0.8, which is 80% of the maximum available achievable rate. And so we see that what is interesting is that when we add some picocells, we can actually have a fine the performances of the system increase, in the sense that some of the guys will be able to emit their video at the minimum level, so we kind of save these guys, but some others will be able to have a better quality of experience. And so we see that people here can have almost 0.9 as a quality of experience, which means that we are able to a little bit better exploit the capabilities of the encoders, and to exploit the encoders' ability to scale and to increase the quality of the video. So in conclusion, to the best of our knowledge, it's the first model, first theoretical model, optimization model for the uplink, okay? So for the video uploading. There are some works on the downlink, but they have some issues. So we still have a solution for the chicken egg problem that I just mentioned, which is not as elegant as it could be. So it's, it could be possible to improve the theoretical model in order to get rid of this small trick, in fact. But it's not easy, actually. We are in the process of doing it, but if you are interested, then we can have a discussion. Our model is a little bit simplistic in the sense that we consider that all the videos that were transmitted by the users at the same were the same. Actually, we use one quantitative videos, and when you are catching videos with your smartphone, you can have a different videos. So typically, if you are capturing the football field, and if you are capturing the crowd all around, it may be not the same kind of input, and so you could have a different quality of experience function, and so it could be put into the process. And of course, this is an optimality, an optimal model which requires time. So typically, with 1,000 users, we have something like three hours to solve the solution. So not something that we could implement into the network. So we need to develop heuristics which are as quasi optimal as possible in order to have actual strategies. Thank you.
So any questions on the audience?
I have probably a naive question. So when you're recording a video, do you expect the queuing to change for a given video? I mean, it's your last point, essentially. Do you need to keep doing this often when you're recording a video, or it's a one-time operation that sort of you can do once and forget? Do you need to retrain the optimization?
I mean, in the real life or in our model?
No, in real life. How do you?
In the real life, if you use WebRTC technologies or similar technologies, we use WebRTC because it's popular now. the encoding is, I mean, the bit rate of your encoders can vary according to the available bandwidth that you have. So it means that it is expected to adapt to your channel.
So you'd have to do this as often as the bit rate changes, essentially, because you have queuing the function only of bit rate.
We are doing in our model is for an offline computation. So it means that we take a snapshot of the system and we say, okay, if this is a snapshot, let's try to see what are the optimal performances that we could achieve. Actually, nobody can achieve that, or it's like. But so we compute a solution where we say, okay, with this channel, these guys could have sent the video with that bit rate, and so we could have that quality of response.
You also assume that your client, your sending device, is adapting its power levels, right? Is that already realistic in most devices nowadays?
It seems so. That means that the device can decide the transmission power just enough to achieve a sufficient channel capacity of the transmission.
Right.
It was a cellular network part.
Yeah, it was just one of the. A couple of years ago, at least in Wi-Fi networks, most transmitters that you have for laptops or mobile phones, they were not capable yet to scale it down, and I don't know if that's.
Yeah, it's in the 4G clients, the 4G compatible devices, this is a kind of thing that officials has to be. Probably we had one reference in the paper for this. We tried to back up everything which was a bit critical like this. We were not totally sure, so when we got the answer from an expert, we said, okay, give us the reference. So if we don't have references, maybe it's
so, any other questions? If not, let's think on the other weekend.